Let's do it.
TIG welding a 2-inch socket weld today on a positioner at 140 amps. It's going to be a 3-pass weld, and I'm going to be walking the cup using a number 6 cup for the first pass or the root pass. It's a large diameter gas lens setup on an air-cooled CK17 style torch. A CK150 with a flex head. So the electrode extension when you're walking the cup like this is kind of important. Also cup size is, because if you choose too large of a cup size for this first pass, the cup will just kind of rock back and forth between the lip of the socket fitting and the wall of the pipe. It's not as smooth as just wiggling it. So if you can pick the right size cup, you can just wiggle it along, just barely wiggle it. Keeps the root pass really narrow, keeps that arc focused right on the tip of the rod, and kind of drives the penetration right in there if you're using the right amperage. And again, I'm 140 amps. I'm using a 332 filler metal for this first pass to make sure I get penetration. And because the socket weld fitting is carbon steel and this little short pipe nipple is stainless, I'm using 309 filler. This is actually a lot of fun to weld on a positioner like this on brand new clean metal. Nothing's in the way. This is the kind of weld that makes you feel better about yourself. Well, that's one pass. We'll let it cool just a little bit. It's like doing this on a regular T-joint. If you want to get some practice, just set up a T-joint like this. You may have to set it toward the edge of the table just because, you know, walking the cup works better on round stuff. But if you put it on the edge of the table, you can get your settings dialed in and get some practice just on a regular T-joint. And here's my setup again. A number 6 cup for that first pass, and I'll use a 6 on the second pass, but then I'll switch over to a number 8 for the cover pass. So it's cooled off for a minute here. Time to put that second one on. I'll be weaving a little bit wider here. I thought it would be kind of helpful to show this before I do that pass. This is that same T-joint that I ran that really narrow root pass in a minute ago, and it's good practice to come across it with a second pass. This is pretty much the same thing I'll be doing on the socket weld fitting. You got to get your electrode extension right. Got to kind of get the feel right. Got to choose the right size cup. All the same stuff that you need to do to make a good looking socket weld. There's a lot of discussion on what the minimum fillet weld size is for a socket weld. And generally speaking, there's several different codes that kind of govern that. And one is the ASME B31 pipe welding code. So there's a B31.1, that's for power piping, and there's a B31.3 for process piping. And they have certain call-outs for minimum weld size for socket weld fittings, but then inspectors also are opinionated on that. So when, you know, this second pass might very well be enough for this particular wall thickness of this pipe, a lot of inspectors would want you to carry it all the way out to the lip or the edge of the socket weld fitting. So that's kind of what I'm going to do today. After this pass, I'm going to put a third pass on it. But before the third pass, I will let it cool for just a couple of minutes. Such a small piece here, things are getting kind of hot. Let's take a quick look at it. It looks like I'm in pretty good shape to put a cover pass on there and take it all the way out to the edge of the fitting. So I'm going to let that cool off for just a few minutes. Things will go a little bit better once it's had a chance to cool off. Here are my settings again and the cup sizes that I use for the first and second pass. And now it's time to switch to a larger cup. I'm going to a number 8. And as you'll see on the arc shot, I extended the electrode out probably just a little too far. It worked, but I was borderline, you know, extended too far. It was really laid back there, which kind of helps us all see what's going on a little bit better, so I'm not too sad about that. But I probably extended it about a 16th further than I normally would. And like I said, it worked out for the best because we could all see the arc shots a little bit better without the cup blocking the tip of the electrode. Sometimes things work out. Now if I got really comfortable with this, I'd probably go up in amperage and go quite a bit faster, but it's been a while, so you know, I'm slowing things down a little bit. I've got the turntable set on a little bit less than 1 RPM, and we're just about to wrap this joint up. I've got a few more little clips of similar walking the cup stuff to show you, but that one's done. Now, if you would like to see this video, I'll try to link it up right here. This is a stainless steel multiple pass fillet weld that I did, kind of showing the arc shots and walking the cup. I put several passes on here like you sometimes have to do on a double extra heavy wall thickness socket weld or slip-on flange or something like that. And coming very soon, I'll do one in a tripod vise, going from bottom to top, because that's what you have to do a lot of times when you're either welding a tie-in joint or you've got an offset on there that's just so long it's not practical to flip it. So some tips for that coming soon. And if you enjoyed this video, I do believe you'll enjoy the one in the tripod vise too, because good arc shots with settings along with plenty of tips. Socket welds are something that are typically not taught in many schools. Even schools that do pipe don't typically teach you socket welds. It's just kind of something you got to learn on the job. That's what I did anyway. But my hope is that this will help somebody, shorten somebody's learning curve, help somebody get a job. I put together these TIG Pro kits, and they have all the cups that I use in this video, as well as a cup for practically every situation you could ever encounter, practically every cup you've ever seen me use in a video. You can learn more at weldmonger.com.